Westlife, how's it going? Nice to see you again.
Oh, hi, John. Great. How's it going, John, buddy?
It's been a while, and great to see the announcement then today. Two big Christmas shows coming up for Belfast. You can't keep away, can you?
No, we're super buzzing, to be honest. You know, this is actually going to be our first time to ever play in Belfast around Christmas time to do a proper concert. So it's our first kind of ever Christmas tour, to be honest. So it's really, really exciting. Obviously, after the pandemic and everything that's happened in the world in the last few years, we're just buzzing to get back on that stage and, you know, do our thing again.
I'm sure you are. And of course, it's the hit show. I mean, in many ways, so many Westlife shows are a hit show because of the amount you've actually had. But have you thought about the set list in particular for this one? It's been tough to put together.
We are lucky enough, and obviously thanks to all the fans, to have enough kind of songs or hit songs that you sort of find it hard to choose. It's more of which ones you leave out of the set list rather than which ones you put into it, because you've only got a certain amount of time to do the show in, or we'll be there for like 4 hours. It is always a bit of a kind of mountain to climb, but we always get there in the end.
We avoid it for a long time.
Yeah, we do. We seem to avoid it.
Some of us are still avoiding.
We're still avoiding it, some of us.
Like, you might get about 10 emails if we decide to dive
Maybe
in.
Maybe I might actually look at that today.
But anyways, yeah, the set list, to be honest, is very exciting because the set list is the backbone of the whole show, you know? And so, it's always fun to remind ourselves of the songs we have, and then you start thinking about the lights and the staging and the clothes and everything and the crowd once the set list starts coming together. So it's very much the meat and bones of the whole thing, you know.
But it's also, you'll never keep everyone happy because you'll always end up leaving out somebody's favourite. I don't mean in us, I mean in fans' favourite. And it's the same for us. There's some, on the reunion tour, we had that headache where we actually were in production rehearsals and there was one song in particular, maybe even two. Shane really wanted to do Fool Again, I think, on the reunion, which didn't make the cut. I really wanted to do Safe. That didn't make the cut.
Fool Again did make the cut, though.
In a little bit, yeah. Right. But I think Safe, Safe should be in this one. And already there.
You got it.
So this year, we're definitely considering doing some. It's not like they're off the beaten track. Like a song like Safe or Already There is very well known by your fans. But we've tended to go for the real proper one that was like number one for whatever weeks. We're definitely going to consider just broadening the horizon a little bit. And we're not going to do songs people don't know, but maybe songs that haven't seen as much light as they should have over the last 10 years, you know?
Sure. So in other words, you're not going to do my favorite Westlife song, which is called She's Back.
Oh, yeah.
She's back again.
We definitely
get that in there.
Did we ever do that?
We did it with Billie Jean. In a medley.
We tried to do that with the gloves and everything.
I remember that, yeah. And also, of course, your love affair with Northern Ireland is amazing. I mean, I read today, is it 65 shows and counting, whether it's the SSE or in its previous incarnation, the Odyssey, but 65?
Yeah, it's incredible. The relationship with Belfast over the years and Northern Ireland has been unbelievable since day one. And we don't know what it is, but we have, you know, probably more fans per population than anywhere else in the world, in Northern Ireland, and it's probably the closest place to us. So it's incredible, you know. We've had some amazing memories over the years up there, and as you said, 65 shows. So now we'd be officially doing 67, which is, you know, in one arena in one city is incredible. We don't have that anywhere else in the world, so it shows you the love we have in Belfast.
You know, when we went reunion, we wondered would the chaoticness be the same, because we all have those vivid memories of
we're
the
all
early
old
days
now.
thousands of fans, like hundreds of fans, definitely hundreds, maybe thousands, outside hotels, running after cars. And I remember at the really crazy days, we'd fly in sometimes on a jet to do maybe Children in Need or the Kelly Show. Yeah. And then we'd have to get back on a plane to get back to wherever. And fans Scratch would be in cars and chasing us to the, you know, to the airport. And it was just chaotic. And then we came up after our 8-year kind of hiatus to the SSE arena to announce those shows. It was back, wasn't it?
It was
500 people there again. Now these you know, women are in their, you know, 30s now and probably their own children, and could have been 40s or 50s. I mean, the great thing was, and what's great about a band like Westlife is those shows that then leads into the shows. The shows are real events, you know. They're now, it's grown up, it's couples, it's families, it's all that type of thing. And equally for us coming to the SSE, with great memories of our own families, us as teenagers, but then growing up as well, and now our own kids come along, you know, our parents, the ones obviously that are thankfully still around, that type of stuff. You know, it's a real family affair. So it's definitely got a special place in our heart. The reunion tour, we opened there, right on stage in 8-9 years when we did that a few years ago. So we knew even if we were rubbish on the night that Belfast were going to give us a great welcome, and they did. And
we were rubbish though.
That's it. I remember as well, Shane, particularly you telling me about loving a night out in Belfast. I remember we were talking about, you know, say you were even in Sligo and you were saying, would I go to Dublin for a night out or Belfast? And Belfast seemed to get the nod. Is that still the case?
Well, to be honest, it's a bit of both. I don't go out as much as I used to, obviously, back in the day. But, you know, we just had great memories up there, great nights out. We used to go up there and do like 10 shows, you know.
And 10 nights out.
We'd have probably 11 nights out. 10 shows.
I think what was great for us as well as for the Sligo lads, you know, we would have a lot of people come from, because it's just as easy to get to Belfast as it is to get to Dublin. So we would have loads of friends and family come up to Belfast us the whole time. And we used to always say to them, no, come to Belfast. Belfast has got such energy. You're never going to experience. Like, honestly, I think as the years have rolled on, Belfast as an audience is still probably the loudest audience that we have. Maybe one or two audiences in Asia come close. But apart from that, Belfast just has that atmosphere about it for Westlife. Like you said, it is a love affair. You know, we don't know how it came about, but you know, we're just happy that it's there, and we never want to break up with Belfast. Let's put it that way.
We actually used to, it's very odd and rare that the venue we play in also has a nightclub upstairs in it. And so we used to go directly the stage, change in our dressing room, refresh up, and upstairs in the arena. So
I remember that. Yeah, that's right.
If it's not still open, it will be open on the 15th.
Yeah. We'll reopen it for you.
The age that want to go to the nightclub while we go back to bed.
Yeah. We'll have to have our Christmas party now.
I'll be sneaking Rocco and Jay a wee beer. Come on.
Well, that's the thing. The Christmas party is in Belfast. We look forward to it, boys. Always a pleasure. And you know you're welcome on Cool FM all the time. We look forward to those two shows. And if you want to give the fans a shout out, this is your moment. You can look down the lens there and say hello to them.
Hi, everybody. We're Westlife and we cannot wait to get to Belfast for these shows. Belfast is always a serious night out for us and a serious night on the stage. Our fans are amazing. We love you. We can't wait to see you there.